So far, we've seen that Mastercam Deburr is the clear solution for speed when it comes to chamfering or deburring a part like this. Now, there is something even beyond just the speed, right? We're gonna make this toolpath really fast, but Mastercam Deburr is infinitely more accurate when compared to the contour toolpath. So let's create a couple quick toolpaths and I'll show you what I mean. We're gonna open a Deburr three-axis toolpath here with a ball mill. Just like before, I'm gonna define my entire solid body. And I'm gonna constrain this to one single loop. If I hold down the shift key and click, we're gonna chain this entire tangent loop. And let's say I wanna make a 7/1000ths break edge. Say okay. And we're given a really nice looking deburr toolpath. Let's do the same thing with contour now. Shift click, just the same. Make sure our ball mill is selected. This is a 3D chamfer this time. And for this, I'm gonna say it's about 5/1000ths width and 5/1000ths in depth. That's gonna give us about a 7/1000ths chamfer to be equal. And there's that toolpath. So let's select both of these toolpaths and go into verify, and I'll show you just how the comparison between them looks. So here we can see the result of that deburr toolpath. This is a beautiful uniform break edge all the way around this path. Now, if I just skip right to the end of the contour toolpath, watch what happens. You can see this entire wall of the part is over-engaged by the cutter, and everywhere else where there's flat seems to match up perfectly. So really, the contour is a great option as long as you're working on nice, simple, flat geometry. But as soon as there's a slope involved, the deburr toolpath, again, becomes the clear-cut winner. Back in Mastercam, this exact thing is also true when you change over to chamfers. So we could either add multipass chamfering with a deburr toolpath and a ball mill, or I can select a chamfer mill, and let's go up to say 20/1000ths of width, and do the same thing in our contour toolpath as well. Chamfer mill, 20/1000ths. Here we have to manually make sure that our top or bottom offset is acceptable. This toolpath may or may not generate the first time. Looks like we're good. Run it and verify. So I skipped right through the deburr toolpath, and again, we have a beautiful uniform chamfer. Skip to the end of the contour, and again, it over-engages, and you can see down at the bottom here as the slope begins that we have a much larger chamfer, and it kind of varies and becomes less as it reaches the top of the part. So from here, again, we can see that deburr is not only faster, it is more accurate than the classic options in Mastercam. And not only is it more accurate, it is far safer. In the next video, we're going to talk about the collision awareness that the deburr toolpath has.